Rano, rano, rani.
Hi there, I'm Victor Merinsky, videographer and editor. I'm sitting in for Kaz, who's under the weather tonight, and welcome to our special show tonight. We have, as you know, as time goes on, things change. Well, sometimes for the better, sometimes for the worse. Well, tonight we're going to be talking about one of the changes in Reading, and it's all about Nativity, BVM, Ukrainian Catholic Church, and their move out of the city. Our special guest is Cindy Koretsky, who's going to be informing us, and I hope George Meiser is listening, because there's a lot of information there he'd be interested in. To verify. So welcome, Cindy, to the
show.
Thank
you very much, Victor. And in Ukrainian style during this Easter time, we greet everybody with Christos Voskres, Christ is risen. Veliyasen Voskres, indeed he is risen. Our church goes back late 1800s, and that's when the Ukrainian Catholic Church originated and opened first in the Milmont area of the city of Reading. In 1906, we moved down to the Laurel Street location, and the church was sold that the Polish people in the Milmont area had a place to worship, and we moved across the bridge into the city to the Laurel Street location. And that was our first church at 632 Laurel Street. Around 1953, the cornerstone was laid for the building that we just vacated, and it opened late 1954, and the original building was better known as the Pierogi House, where all the ladies from the church got together and made the pierogis, as the Polish people call them, and that tradition still continues in our new place, and I'll get into that a little bit later. And then in 1960, around the 1960s, land was purchased in Cumru Township, and our cemetery and the picnic grove, the Flying Hills venue that everybody is aware of, and had many picnics there, and everybody, I'm sure the older people and us, my age, the younger people, we had many, many good times and Polish picnics up there and wedding receptions and showers and had a really good time up there. They still exist and our cemetery is still there. And then around 2009 or there or shortly after, plans were being made to build a new church and a new facility out in the Cumru Township area where we own the land. And sometime in the beginning of 2015, the opportunity came up of St. Anthony's merging with St. John the Baptist, and we were offered to buy back our original place where we started out in Berks County, back in the Milmont area of the city of Reading.
Boy, is that interesting.
Full circle.
I bet not many people know that.
We're full circle. It was on St. Anthony's homepage for the longest time, and when it came about that we were offered to buy and reobtain the areas over in Milmont where we presently are, everybody was like, well, this is where the Ukrainians started out in Berks County, and a lot of us were surprised because we were not aware. It was always Laurel Street. So, and back in 1995, St. Pope John Paul II said that the church must breathe with her two lungs. The Western and Eastern churches are inseparable parts of the Catholic Church, so the Roman Catholics and the Ukrainian Catholics are all part of the whole Catholic religion, and we still are governed by the Pope. A lot of people don't think we are, that we're different. We are different, but we're very similar to the Roman Catholics as well. And we look forward to opening our doors to the area, area, community, to the neighbors. Any event that we have, which I'll be going over shortly, any event that we have is always open to the public. We want people to see what we have. We want to help people. We, for a while down at the Laurel Street Church, we did have English as a second language classes for anybody that spoke any language. We had an instructor there. We have catechism classes for the children. We had adult catechism classes. Our present pastor, Father Andrei Rabi, was also teaching Ukrainian language classes for those of us that were interested. So we're quite active, and since we moved over to the Milmont area, our first event there back in December was our Christmas bazaar. And when I got there a little after 12 o'clock, people were lined up down the street and around the corner for like two blocks waiting to get in, which was very, very nice for us. We had a holiday polka party in the middle of December.
And you had the same lineup of people waiting for food. We tried it. We said, oh, we'll go early. Sure, we'll go. We should have came before sunrise.
Well, you know, that doesn't hurt. We had the consecration and our first liturgy at the beginning, like New Year's weekend. And since then, we've hosted Lenten meals and fish fries. We had a Ukrainian Easter egg decorating class, the Pisanki class. One of our parishioners, her sister, presented the class, and she had about 20 to 25 people there, and I felt so bad when I found out the one lady, she worked so diligently and hard on an egg for 3 hours, and that she was leaving and they were packing it up, it fell on the floor and broke. I just felt so bad for her. This coming Friday, we had an Easter bazaar also. It was the day before Palm Sunday, and that was another instance where people were lined up and around the corner. And this coming Friday, we will be having a food sale at the parish hall at 211 Grace Street, and we will be having the three different kinds of the pierogies, the sauerkraut, potato, and cheese. We will also be having galumpkis and nut roll, apricot, poppy roll, and the round and long breads, the sweet bread, plain, and raisin.
Now, where are the samples for us? How do we know you're telling them? You're not just fibbing. We need samples.
You show up on Friday, and I'll make sure you and Jerry get something.
Oh, I got to wait that long.
Well, I have connections that maybe we might not run out of time if I have somebody come and bring you something.
We'll wait.
That's not a problem. And this coming Sunday, we have our annual Easter Sfirtene dinner, an Easter egg hunt for the children. And like I said, again, anything that we have, anything that we host, is open to the public. We want people to come. We want people to enjoy what we have. We love to share this stuff. And I tell people that I work with at the Reading Hospital, that's what we do. We pray and we feed people. Yeah. Bottom line, that's what we do. Okay. In the month of May, we plan on having a flower sale for Mother's Day in front of the church at 9 o'clock till 4 o'clock in the afternoon, so there's no excuse not to get somebody's mom their flowers. We'll have them at the church. And Mother's Day brunch is hosted by us at the hall from 10:30 to 1:30, or 12:30 on Mother's Day. Tickets in advance are available, and there's going to be an increase in price at the door. And there's going to be a family casino night. We'll have casino games for children as well as adults. It's a Father's Day family geared towards type thing. And again, everybody is welcome, families, and it's geared because it's Father's Day. It's not just men, it's family oriented. That's what we try and get in the younger people.
You must have quite a congregation there. Well, everybody that's there is working himself to death.
Pretty much so, but it's all for the grace of God. And I was told by many priests a number of times, if you're not doing it for the grace of God, you're doing it for the wrong reason.
Oh.
So that's what we live by.
Well, you really have quite a lineup of
Well, Father Andre likes to keep us busy, too.
Well, doesn't that mean he's involved in everything?
Oh my goodness, yes. He's involved with more than a lot of people realize, and he has been a godsend to us. Since he's been with us, we have gotten so many things accomplished, and we have gotten more parishioners, and it's just the family. And that's the way it used to be when I was growing up. It was a family thing to go to church. And that's the way we're trying to make this now, so the younger people can appreciate and carry on the traditions that we've started.
Well, we have some video from the dance. So as soon as Joan is ready, get that video.
We had a good turnout. There was over 100 people there. And Crabtown Sound out of Baltimore, Maryland came to play for us.
Yeah, they were great.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, let's go with the video.
Thank you.
Got to see some of the good fun things we had there. We have a couple things coming up. The Viennese Ball concert and the Polish Open, which orchestra. This is a fundraiser for the Animal Rescue League. Down at Sunnybrook, actually it's a week from Saturday. Yeah. It's April 23rd, and you can call Joe or Ellen Groller at 610-435-7726. It's a wonderful day with food and music and all kinds, different types of music. So we go there every year too. It's great. Now we can go to the Manor Golf Club for the Polish-American Heritage. They have the annual Open, the Polish Open at Manor Golf Club, May 14th, over in Sinking Spring. You can call Tony Wade at 484-333-2838. And the deadline is May 6th, 2016. They always have a good turnout for that, and hope Mother Nature cooperates. And getting out to the end of the line, Cindy, it's been a pleasure having all your useful information.
Thank you very much.
I hope George Meiser is listening, because he'll be right on top of this, too.
That's fine. If anybody has any questions, feel free to call our rectory. Yeah. Father's usually available to answer any questions. And the rectory phone number is 610-376-0586. Or just come to any of our events or activities. And anybody that's on the committee or any parishioner, I'm sure we'd be happy to help somebody out. And our next event, like I said, is the food sale coming up on Friday from 3 to 6 at 211 Grace Street. And come over and say hello, and I'll be there.
That beautiful hall you got there now, wow, that's
we're very blessed
plus
to be where we are. We are very blessed, and we'd like to share that with everybody.
And
the hall is also available for rental.
Well, that's great.
If anybody's interested, again, call the rectory Ellen at 610-207-7875, and she'll be able to help you out with the hall rental as well.
OK. Okay, well, I hope somebody's watching and have some of these samples.
Thank you.
In the lobby a few minutes.
Absolutely.
Can they have coffee out there? So,
sure. And I want to thank you and Kaz for allowing me to come in to speak about the Ukrainian church in Reading. It was my pleasure.
Oh, it was good information.
Thank you for being here. You're very welcome.
And we give our best regards to Kaz. Hope he's better for the next show.
Yes.
If not...
And didn't you say this was a monumental show? This was the Baker's
Dozen
show?
Oh, yeah, this is the Baker's Dozen show, or 13th show.
Mm-hmm. So. And I'm on it. I don't know about that.
I hope it's not a closing show.
No.
I'll have to say goodnight to everyone, and thank you for watching, and hope to see you again next time.
Thank you.
Celebration, you bring your friends out.